Hi everybody, nice to see you again, and I'm going to introduce the next speaker. It's Zoltán Sziki. He's an assistant professor at the Budapest University of Technology and Economics. He's also head of the Geo4All Lab at the university, and he's going to present a project to recognize the, automatically some GCP points from UAV images. Hi, Zoltán.
Hi, thank you. I start sharing my screen.
Yes, thanks. Okay.
Can you see it?
Yeah, I can see it. And you can put on presentation mode, please.
Yes, I am in presentation mode.
Now we see the LibreOffice application right now.
Okay. Then I have to change something with the display settings. Sorry.
No problem. Probably you have to put the main screen on the other device.
Maybe you are right. Is it okay now?
No, it's the same. Probably I remove the share and try to share again, please. Now you have to stop to share and share again.
Okay.
Same as before.
Okay, then I change to single display.
Yeah, sorry.
And I start now. I hope so. It's okay.
Try to close the stream to share and share again, because I keep the old configuration.
Okay.
So Zoltán has some problem to share the presentation, okay.
Is it okay now?
You have to share again because you collapsed.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, sorry.
No problem. Okay, now it's fine. This should take
okay. Okay. So after this technical problem, I would like to welcome you to my presentation. I would like to introduce you a small open source development from our Geo4All Lab at Budapest University of Technology and Economy. This is related to unmanned aerial vehicles, which are commonly called drones, and photogrammetry and automation. Let me introduce myself. Luca has mentioned several things from here. Besides being an open source fan, I work for the university and I have some OSGO and FOSS4G activities in Hungary and in the international team. Let's speak about the outlines. I will introduce you some important points like ArUco markers and GCP. Yes, it's a typing mistake here on my side. And our development belongs to ODM, the Open Drone Map, which is the standard drone image processing or photogrammetry processing software in the open source world. And then I will introduce the functionality of our program, and to make the life more comfortable, we write some utility programs along with our main program. What are the ArUco markers? ArUco markers are mostly used for artificial, augmented reality. It is the abbreviation of Augmented Reality University Cordoba. So it was developed in Spain. They are small two-dimensional barcodes. Each ArUco marker corresponds to an integer value, and it is encoded into black and white squares. There are different grid sizes from 3 to 7 to 7, and there is a module for OpenCV library for detecting ArUco markers in images. One of the ArUco marker has an axial or central symmetry, so not only the marker can be detected in the images, but the orientation also. What are GCPs? This is the shortage for ground control points. These are known points with known coordinates, and it must be, or they must be visible on the images. We may use natural markers, which can be identified on the images, or we can put artificial markers, like here, on the field before taking the photos from the drone. For our purposes, only special artificial markers can be used, which has a unique pattern or a unique ID like ArUco markers. You can see enlarging these parts. The coordinates for the ArUco markers are usually measured on the field by a GPS receiver. OpenDroneMap is a quite new open source development. It was started in 2014, and it is the de facto standard open source drone image processing tool in the open source world. It is recommended to use in a Docker container. and it has only command line interface. This is a sample how to start processing of drone images. It may create several different outputs through orthophotos, point clouds, digital terrain models, digital surface models, and mesh object models are available. These are optional to show you the difference between normal and true orthophoto. This is the normal and this is the true orthophoto when the walls are not visible, so the roof is moved above the base of the building, so it won't hide anything. Okay, the ODM project has 9 different sub-projects, which are not discussed here. I only mentioned you ODM, and the other one, which we use together with our development, is called WebODM. WebODM is a graphical interface to the ODM program, which can be used in a browser. So it's more comfortable than the command line, and it has not only functionality to create and process projects, but it gives you the chance to see your the result of your project. Here, for example, a point cloud displayed in Pot3, which is another open source project which is used here. Leaflet is used to display orthophotos and some map background. About the program. The aim of the program is to find the ground control points automatic without human work. It is not involved yet in ODM, so in ODM you can manually mark only these GCPs. It takes all the images which comes from the drone camera. We need the world coordinate list of the ArUco markers which were measured by GPS or under other surveying methods, and it has some command line parameters. It has also only a command line interface, and inside the program we use OpenCV and the ArUco module of OpenCV, NumPy, and for display purposes we use matplotlib, and the result is a text file which looks like this, which is required by the ODM or web ODM program. It contains the coordinate reference, the coordinates of the points in your target coordinate reference system, the image coordinates, and image name. Here the last value is the encoded ID of the marker, which is optional. So here it's an output, graphical output program. The program here, the marker means it, here an ArUco marker was found. I enlarge it, it looks like this. This was the original one. It's quite easy to realize. The ArUco marker module first convert the image into binary black and white image, and then it try to find the outline rectangle of the marker, and then it transform back from it. Of course, it's distorted on the image, and it change back to a rectangular shape, and then put on a grid to find black and white markers. Here again the result file. The program is available on the GitHub, so you can try it. There is a short documentation for the program. We have several command line parameters. Most of them is inherited from the ArUco marker detection module of OpenCV. We have had some problem with the detection of markers. One problem was the so-called burnt or burnt-in effect. In sunshine, the area of the white squares on the marker are increased and the black one is decreased. This sometimes cause the marker is not detected, or the ID is false detected. To avoid this, we can use the ignore parameter, which causes that we can ignore the outer part of these grid cells, so only the green part will be considered, and it can help to make the marker found. The other idea which we tried is that instead of the white color, let's use gray color. Fortunately, the ArUco module use adaptive filter for changing or converting the image into black and white, so gray can be used also, and here you can see on the gray the burnt-in effect is much lower than in the left side case. The other problem is that we sometimes have false positive matches. It's mostly in built environment where many rectangular shapes can be on the image. For example, here these two chimneys were detected as this marker. And some other false matches. We can reduce the possibility of false matches to give a minimum and maximum size for the markers on the image, and only those IDs will be found which is in the coordinate list, so it can reduce the number of false detection, but you cannot be sure, so you have to quick review of the found markers. To have some help, more help to use the program, we created some utilities. ArUco can create a printable marker which you can print out and you can put on the field. The DictGAN 3x3 is a program which can generate the non-standard 3x3 grid markers. We have an exit pos utility which can collect the GPS position from the images, and for example you can display the image positions in QGIS or other GIS software. GCP check is used to visually check the found markers. You can zoom in, zoom out, and you can check whether these markers are detected correctly. GSD Calc was created by the demand of the ODM community members. It helps you to find out how large markers should be put on the field to be able for the program to detect. I have an image about this. It's a web service. Here is a link where you can reach this web service, but the source code is also available on the GitHub, so you can set up your own service. Here we have a small database about different drone camera parameters, and if you select one camera from here, or you can fill these values, then you can give the flight height and the ArUco size, then you get the ground sample distance, which is the size of a pixel on the field, in this case 1.4 centimeter, and you get an estimation. In this case you should use at least 25 centimeter ArUco markers to be able to find by our program. If you use larger, it's no problem. If you use smaller, then the detection won't be available. We had the chance to introduce our program on the blog of the ODM, so you can read some more information about this on the blog of the on the ODM homepage. So that was all, folks, and I would my aim is was to prove you not only big project can be useful. In this case we have a pure Python code, less than 1,000 lines, and it can help the work of the whole community. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Zoltan. It was a really interesting talk, especially for me that I'm using the drone a little bit. There are no questions from the audience, but I have a couple for you.
Okay. So,
the UARCO GCP, is it possible to plastify them or something like that?
Yes, but you have to be careful. Do not use reflective material, because that case, the burnt-in effect, it was our first mistake. We use a plastic board with black foils, but it was reflective, so it was not useful in sunny days, only in cloudy days.
Okay. And how many pictures or how many GCP are recognized for the picture? Because I know that the ODM developer told me that it's enough to write 5 picture with the for each GCP. It is recognizing all the GCP in the entire
Yes. And I suppose that the offered overlapping between images is 75-83%, and then one GCP maybe on 10 images, and all of them is can be found.
Okay, so maybe could be an improvement for the future, just to limit so to a certain number of picture to write in the output file, because Pietro told me that if you put too many images in the GCP list file, this could be worse than put just 5 or 4 to 6.
I haven't heard this restriction. I suppose that if you have the GPCs on several images, it may improve accuracy of your final model.
Yeah, I was thinking the same, but
okay. It's I don't know.
Let's see if there are some questions from the audience or no more questions. So thanks a lot. It was really interesting, and I will use in the future. I have to print some ARUCO code, and I'll let you know something about.
Okay. Ask me if you need help. See you, Luca.
Okay. Bye.
Bye-bye.
So then the next talk will be in 3 minutes, more or less. So see you soon.